Hi children, welcome you all to the geography online class. Today we are going to see chapter 5, that is major limbs of the earth. In this chapter we are going to see about lithosphere, hydrosphere, and what is atmosphere and biosphere, the domain of life. Earth is the one and only planet which supports the life. This is because there is land, air, and water on it. Each of these three elements constitute a separate realm on Earth. A realm is a major biogeographical division of the Earth's surface. Lithosphere was made up of land, and water makes up the hydrosphere, and air makes up the atmosphere. The zone where all these three, lithosphere, hydrosphere, atmosphere, that is land, water and air, meets and interact and overlap, the zone is called biosphere. The biosphere is the realm made up of living things and the environment where they live. Lithosphere. In the land, the earth has three main layers. The innermost layer is known as core, the layer in the middle is the mantle, and the outermost layer is called crust. The crust and the upper portion of the mantle together form the lithosphere. See, in this picture, the details was elaborate. See here, the innermost layer is called core, and the outer layer is called crust, and the layer in the middle is called mantle. So this is the picture of lithosphere. Lithosphere. We all know that land makes up lithosphere. The lithosphere consists of huge masses of land known as continents. It also includes the land that lies below the ocean known as ocean beds. There are seven continents in the world: Asia, Africa, North America, South America, Europe, Australia. It's also known as Oceania and Antarctica. So there are totally seven continents. See, these are the continents in the world map. See, the seven continents present here. The Oceania refers to Australia. The first continent we are going to see is Asia. Asia is the largest continent in the world. When compared to other six continents, Asia is the largest. It covers about one-third of the total land area of the earth. The Arctic Ocean lies to its north, the Pacific Ocean to the east, and the Indian Ocean to the south. See, this is the Asia map. In Asia, the lines equator, the Tropic of Cancer, and the Arctic Circle passes through this continent. Asia is separated from Europe by the Ural Mountains on the west. The land of Europe and Asia was combined in a landmass called Eurasia. That is Europe plus Asia. It is called Eurasia. The second continent is Africa. Africa is the second largest continent on Earth. The Atlantic Ocean lies to its west, the Indian Ocean to the east and the south, and the Mediterranean Sea to its north. The lines, the Tropic of Cancer, the Equator and the Tropic of Capricorn pass through this Africa. The longest river in the world, Nile, and the biggest desert, the Sahara, lies in the Africa continent. Dense rainforests are found in Central Africa. Now we are going to see about North America. North America is the third largest continent in the world. It is bounded on the north by the Arctic Ocean, on the east by Atlantic Ocean, and on the west by the Pacific Ocean. The Tropic of Cancer and Arctic Circle run through this continent. Several mighty mountain chains, the length of this continent, like the Rockies and the Appalachian, are found in North America. The biggest freshwater lake in the world, that is Lake Superior, lies here. The fourth largest continent in the earth is South America. To the South America, the Pacific Ocean lies to its west, the Atlantic Ocean to its east, and the Southern Ocean to its south. The equator and the Tropic of Capricorn run through this continent. The longest mountain chain in the world, Andes, run along the western edge of this continent. And also, the large part of Amazon rainforest lies in the northern part of South America. Now we are going to see about Antarctica. Antarctica is the fifth largest continent. This is the continent which is covered with full of ice sheets, that is ice glaciers. And Antarctica is completely in the southern hemisphere. It's a huge continent. It is permanently covered with thick layers of ice and snow. There is no permanent human settlement, means there is no people settled permanently in this continent. Some countries have established research stations here. In the previous slide, we come to know that many countries have their research station in Antarctica. In Antarctica, India also has research center named as Maitri and Dakshin Gangotri. See, these are the images of Dakshin Gangotri Research Center and Maitri Research Station. Europe is the sixth largest continent. The Arctic Ocean lies to its north, while the Atlantic Ocean lies to the west, Asia lies to the east. The Arctic Circle passes through Europe. The Alps and the Ural mountain ranges lies here. The river Danube is the longest river of Europe. So this is the image of Europe map. Australia is the smallest continent in the world. When compared to the other six continents, Australia is the smallest. Australia is also called as Oceania. It lies entirely in southern hemisphere. It is surrounded by oceans on all sides. That is, this is the one and only continent which was surrounded by ocean on all sides. The Indian Ocean to its north and the west, the Southern Ocean to its south, and the Atlantic Ocean to its east. The Tropic of Capricorn passes through it. A large part of this continent is a desert. The world's largest coral reef, that is the Great Barrier Reef, is located off the coast of Australia. So, in this chapter, we come to know the Earth is the only planet that supports life. The rillium is a major biogeographical division of the Earth's surface. So, we come to know that land makes up the lithosphere, the hydrosphere, and atmosphere. Where all these three, that is lithosphere, hydrosphere, atmosphere, meet is known as the zone is called biosphere. Lithosphere consists of huge masses of land known as continents. So there are totally seven continents in the world. They are Asia, Africa, North America, South America, Antarctica, Europe, and Australia. So now you are crystal clear about this chapter 5, major realms of the earth. So you are very clear with about this lithosphere. Thank you, children.